Deputy MacDonald, thank you. Deputy MacDonald, please. Deputy MacDonald is called. Sorry, would you stay quiet till Deputy MacDonald puts her question? Thank you.
Gramagat Cian Corla. Tánaiste, so this week you will take up to €87 a week for more than 10,000 single parent families. This is, as you know, the eighth successive cut that you have inflicted on lone parent families. The vast majority of these parents, as you know, are women. Many are in low-paid and insecure jobs. Many more are living in or at risk of poverty. All struggle to raise their children in challenging circumstances. In 2012, Tánaiste, you promised that this cut was dependent on, let me quote you, there being a system of safe, affordable and accessible childcare in place similar to what is found in the Scandinavian countries. You said very definitively that without affordable and accessible childcare, the measure will not proceed. The average cost of childcare is currently €167 a week. In Dublin, it's higher than that. In many communities, as you know, childcare is just not available. Now, when Fianna Fáil cut child benefit, you said that this was anti-woman. Your party said it highlighted the lack of influence of women in cabinet. But yet here we are, you in government, second in command, introducing a measure that is both anti-woman and indeed anti-child. So Tánaiste, why have you broken your solemn commitment that in the absence of accessible and affordable childcare, you would not introduce this cut? And will you, even at this late stage, reverse this cruel and unjust decision to push thousands of one-parent families into poverty?
And thank you for your interest in the issue. And I'm glad, actually, that parties in this House should actually want to debate how, as a country, we help lone parents to move from a situation where, if they're relying on a social welfare income, they are seriously at risk of poverty. And in 2003 and 2004, at the height of the Celtic Tiger and Fianna Fáil's rule in this country, lone parents were at a risk of poverty of somewhere between 30 and 33%. Because of the changes in policy, that has now gone down to 23%, because since we instituted this change over 2 years ago, and this is the third year of the change, the reality is that lone parents risk of being in consistent poverty. It's a very high figure, it's 23%, but during Fianna Fáil's high years, it was 30 and 33%, over 10 points higher. And if a lone parent is not working, their risk of poverty is over 40%. But if they are at work, and particularly if they have family income supplement, their risk of poverty, of consistent poverty, falls below 10%. Now, I find the 10% unacceptable, but I find the 10% infinitely better than either the 30, 33% of Fianna Fáil or the current rate that this government has achieved, and which you spoke about, or your party colleague there on social welfare spoke about in his speech the day before yesterday. So let's be clear on what the objective of this government is. It's to get a group of people parenting with their children on their own, to get them to a situation where their risk and experience of poverty is dramatically reduced. We have done that, as you well know from the information that you have from the department, by creating a transition period of over 7 years to a lone parent returning to work. And that is in recognition, as I told your spokesman there beside you, that is in recognition of the fact that we don't in Ireland at this point in time have the kind of childcare system that I certainly aspire to. And I did that in the context that although, as a government, we're spending €260 million this year on childcare, providing for 100,000 children, it is is still not enough, and I am very ambitious to go further. That's actually what we're spending, and there's a seven-year transition. In the north of Ireland, where your party is in power, the transition age is 5 years of age, and the supports for families are significantly smaller, as you're aware, than they are here.
Thank you,
Now, what we all need in this country is to actually work together, to work with employers, to work with educational institutions, and to work in particular with community organisations to help lone parents who work so hard to actually make the transition to paid employment of a significant amount, so that a lone parent income on social welfare is €218. If they get 19 hours of work and they move to family income supplement, their income goes up to €400 a week. I'd like it to be higher than that, but that's a very good start in helping to get people out of poverty.
Deputy MacDonald.
Well, thank you for that, Tánaiste, and you might consider raising your concerns on issues around the north of Ireland the next time you have an opportunity to speak to David Cameron. You've conspicuously not afforded of those opportunities to raise those issues before. So here's the issue here.
Please.
You see, you're trying to argue, Tánaiste, that the black is white.
Sorry, without interruption, please. Without interruption. Thank you. Would you stay quiet, please?
You're trying to argue that black is white. You're trying to convince a group of families who we all recognise are at risk of poverty, who we all recognise work very hard to raise their children. You're trying to convince them, 10,000 of them, that by reducing their weekly income by €87, you are assisting them out of poverty. No, that's right, Tánaiste. Furthermore, you are attempting to assert that all of the parents who have been at their wits' end, of whom will almost be at despair at this moment because of this cut, have somehow got their figures wrong. Well, let me tell you, Tánaiste, in my experience, people raising children, particularly on their own, when it comes to their household budgets, don't get the figures wrong because they simply cannot afford to. You conspicuously, Ciarán Cóirle, the Tánaiste conspicuously avoided answering the central question at this. You concede that we don't have an adequate childcare provision or system. You made the promise that the very thing you're doing would not proceed until we had adequate, accessible, affordable childcare. You went so far as to pitch your ambition to the Scandinavian model. We've nothing of the sort. And yet you proceed with
this. Thank you,
Deputy. So all of your supposed concern for poverty for lone parents, we all know that one of the big factors, the big, big factors, is the issue of childcare. We also know that if you can't get 19 hours, or if you're not in a position to work 19 hours, that you are in very big difficulties.
Thank you.
And I think instead of being condescending or dismissive on the issue, be aware that there are people, I'm sure, watching this broadcast who are about to lose €87 a week. Some of them will be forced not to get more employment, but in fact to leave employment.
Thank you.
And what do they see? They see a Thatcherite stance from you and a position of utter indifference. Change your mind, Tánaiste, keep your word and stop this cut.
Well, just let me say in relation to that, I'm not aware, Deputy, if you've had the opportunity ever to visit a community-based creche, or if you have any familiarity with the work that is done by my department, where over the last 3 years there's been a complete revamp of community-based childcare into very, very high-quality childcare at very affordable, discounted prices for people going to work. And by the way, in this debate, I want to move to a situation where parents are parents, regardless of their relationship status. I think it's time that this country actually moved on and we acknowledged all parents as equal. But if you take the time out of your busy and important schedule to actually visit community crashes, you will find there now that in fact there's a very high level of childcare provided, which in fact is very much in line with what I have seen as best practice in other countries and which follows very detailed programmes. But I am ambitious.
You may not have had
the time to visit, but I am ambitious to see childcare in this country improved for all parents, because parents who are married deserve to have access to good childcare as well.
And you know,
this debate is instead of just addressing parents, it's focusing on people who just have a particular relationship status. What about a couple, a man and a woman, both of whom perhaps are out working? Is childcare of no concern to them? We want good childcare.
Sorry, we're over time.
Sorry, Deputy. Well, let me tell you on welfare, Jean McConville had 12.
I have to say, would you please adhere to the chair? Thank you. Sorry. Thank you. Thank you. Deputy Wallace. Thank you.